We had a man by the name of Gary Mack. That's how we referred to him. But Gary McCleary, who passed away a couple of months ago today. Yeah. And I was telling Miss Charlotte, and her whole family is here, and I was telling some kids the other day, trying to explain to them, get the concept through to them what good law enforcement is. And I said, y'all just imagine if you're at school, these are small kids. I said, if you're at school and someone's doing something bad to you, whether it's taking your lunch money or whatever it may be, and that school officer walks around the corner, you are going to look at that school officer and you're going to think, thank goodness, you're going to be joyful that that person walked around the corner. The little bad guy is going to have terror in its heart because it's doing wrong. That is the definition of good law enforcement. It is joy to the righteous, and it is terror to the evildoers. And Gary McCleary was joy to the righteous, and he was terror to the evildoers. When I first started here 2 years ago, almost 2 years ago, I didn't know Gary very well. And it wasn't long that we were in here, and he started coming in the office to meet with us, and he was very visible, and so, I don't know any other way to say it except that I felt like when I talked to him, I sometimes felt like a little kid.
We all did.
Yes. And the reason is that I came up with, the reason I feel that way is because for whatever reason, when I was with him, I felt safe. You don't remember when I saw you at the visitation because of everything you were going through, but that's what I told you. I said, Gary McCleary just made me feel safe. He just did. And that's what police and law enforcement are supposed to do. That's what he did in this community. He was a shining example. And here's what happens in this room on a day-to-day basis, is that people are in this room where either they're about to go testify against someone that has hurt them, someone that's dangerous. A lot of times we have little children in here, very young children that have been that trust has been perverted in their lives for a very long time. And what we do in this room is we try to lift their eyes up, help them to see above that, and rebuild and show them what's true and what's right. Since I've been in this office, as an example to me, and I speak for everyone in here, what has been true and right has been Gary McCleary. And when we were trying to figure out what we were going to do, we decided we want to dedicate and consecrate this room in his honor, because he made us feel safe, and I believe that his example is going to make the children that are in this room feel safe as well. We're going to unveil something over here, and I hope I don't pull the ceiling down or anything like that, but Kenny's told me I won't. And this is one of our favorite pictures of Gary McCleary and just how we remember him. And we've got a plaque up here, and it says Lieutenant Gary McCleary, date of birth 3/30/1956, date of death 10/12/2014, 2 months ago. And it says on December 12th, 2014, this room was dedicated to our beloved Gary Mack, who loved family, helping children, and justice. And it says, may you feel peace and hope under his shining example. And then we've got written there Proverbs 4:18. And let me tell you, I wanted to get it exactly right. Let me tell you what that says. Proverbs 4:18 says, but the path of the righteous is like the light of dawn that shines brighter and brighter until the full day. That's Proverbs 4:18. He was a light in this office. He was a light in this community. I remember at the funeral, people talking about kids that would come up to him, and how he had a way with children. And I think his light grew brighter and brighter, and we probably saw the climax of that day at the funeral. I've never experienced anything like that. It was amazing. And we continue to feel that. And we believe that as we use this room for the purpose it is designed, we're going to have kids that say, who is that guy? And we're going to be able to tell them who he is and what he represents to us and to them, that, hey, there's your lighthouse right there, that there are good men in this world. And so you told me today, thank you for doing this, and we want to turn that around. Thank you for letting us do this and sharing him with us. When he would talk to me, he'd talk about you.
I hope it was good.
It was good. It was good. But he's going to be a shining example for us to be able to tell these kids, this is why this room is named after this man. This is who he was. And so just on behalf of all law enforcement in Hopkins County in the 8th Judicial District, we thank you and your whole family, and his parents are here. We thank all of y'all for being here today, and we just look forward to carrying the light that he gave to us on into the future. We've got a plaque on the door as well that we'll unveil that just calls this the Gary McClary Victim Witness Waiting Room. So we are just so honored to have had him in our lives and to continue what he instilled in us.